Good morning, children.
Good morning.
And since we have already started with the prayer, the Hindi prayer, we have done the first paragraph. I'm going to continue with the second paragraph. I have already sent you all the lyrics also so that you all can read the lyrics and learn the prayer. Okay? So it's called Hey Bhagwan, Tujhe Pranam.
Hey Bhagwan, Tujhe Pranam. हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम तेरे बच्चे हम हो सच्चे हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम पढ़ लिखेंगे योग्य बनेंगे नया सीखेंगे करके देखेंगे काम करेंगे नहीं डरेंगे नित्य बढ़ेंगे बढ़ चलेंगे हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम माँ की सुनेंगे दूध पिएंगे पिता की सुनेंगे व्यायाम करेंगे टीचर की सुनेंगे दंगा न करेंगे जल्दी सोएंगे जल्दी उठेंगे हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम
ओके सो यू ऑल विल सिंग दिस प्रेयर टिल हियर एंड सेंड इट टू मी Now let's begin with English. Come to page number 59. Page number 59. We are still doing the chapter Everyday Things. Okay. Now we are on the last part of this chapter. So on the point number 7 and 8. Okay. So we have already finished things you eat, things you drink, things that you wear, things you use, things you can make, things you hear. Everybody has come with different ideas until now, so which is really good. Now we'll do things you can smell. Okay, aap kaun si cheez smell kar sakte ho. So what is given out here is scent. Then there's a flower. Okay, then what else can you smell? What else can you smell? Okay, so something like when even in the kitchen when the food is being made you can smell that then what else you can smell the garbage okay when we give away the garbage you can smell that so that is not a nice smell so it is called a foul smell what is it called foul smell the one which we like to smell and which is nice to smell it can be a perfume a scent a flower yeah So sometimes even the food that we make in the kitchen smells really nice. Okay. So that is again a good smell. Then there is a foul smell of garbage. Okay. Sometimes some people even like to smell when we go out in the garden, wet mud. It smells very nice. Okay. So that smell is also a good smell. Okay. So things you can smell. I will give you 3 sentences on scent. Scent is nothing but perfume. Okay? There will be many people who use perfume in their daily. So it's scent. What can we write? Scent is a liquid. Which smells extremely good. Okay. Then we can write scent. Comes in small glass bottle. Scent is expensive. Okay, scent कभी भी सस्ता नहीं मिलता है, वो इट इज एक्सपेंसिव. सो यू कैन राइट सेंटेंसेस लाइक दिस. ओके, देन यू विल राइट योर ओन सेंटेंसेस ऑन फ्लावर. यू कैन राइट ऑन द फूड विच इज कुक्ड इन द हाउस, द स्मेल ऑफ दैट. यू कैन राइट द गार्बेज स्मेल. यू कैन राइट अबाउट द वेट मड. सो यू कैन राइट वॉट एवर यू वॉन्ट, बट थ्री सेंटेंसेज ऑन दैट. ओके, देन थिंग्स यू केयर फॉर. Okay, there will be things that we care for in life. Okay, for example, here it's written pet animal book. मतलब कौन सी चीज के बारे में आप ध्यान से रखेंगे उसको. Some people like to take care of their house, so they will keep cleaning the house. Okay, some people like to take care of their cars, they will clean the cars very well. Some people like to keep their clothes very well. Okay, so they will nicely fold it, iron it and keep it nicely in their cupboards. So there will be certain things that you like to take care about in your daily life. Okay, so there will be some people who like to take care about their elders in the house. Okay, for example, maybe your parents or grandparents, so you like to take care about them. So you need to write any four. So two are already written, two more you will write, and three sentences on each one of them. Okay, now I'm going to write three sentences on pet animal. So what do we take care about pet animal? So we write here pet animal. First sentence we can write about pet animal. I take my pet dog for a walk every day. Okay. Second sentence you can write, I feed my dog at the right time. Okay. Third, you can write, my dog likes to sleep with me. Okay, so some similar sentences you need to write on other stuff also. So you will write about things you care, that's pet animal, your book. You can write whatever else you like to take care of in your daily routine. Okay, so this is the final. These two you will write sentences in your red and line, blue line books. Take a picture and send. That's all what we need to do for English. Now we are going to do the coloring. Come to page where the fruits are being drawn, the vegetables are there after the scarecrow. Okay, so again, as earlier, if the color coding is written, you need to just color with the same crayons which is mentioned out here. So if R is mentioned, we will color it with a red crayon. Okay. And then if BR is mentioned, we'll color it brown. If DG is mentioned, you will color it with dark green. PUR is purple. L blue is light blue. So what is this? These are the tomatoes. What is it? Tomatoes. what other vegetables can you see after finishing the coloring? Look at what you have colored and see which colors, which vegetables you can actually see. So now we'll just finish the purple. The rest of it is almost done. Okay. After finishing the whole picture, write your name, take a picture and send it to me. There are still a few children who do not write their names. So please write your name on each and every work that you are sending. So this is how you need to color the whole vegetable basket. Okay. Can you all see? Yes. That's what you need to do for coloring. Okay, now for maths, come to page number 73. Page number 73. The topic is what is next. Okay. So what we have to do here is you have to observe the picture. Write proper order of activities. Now when we are doing any activity, even in your daily life, there is a proper process that you follow. Okay. For example, when you get up in the morning, you will go to the toilet. You will first go to the toilet. You will wash your face. You'll brush your teeth. You'll use the toilet. So there is one sequence that you follow. Okay. You'll not get up in the toilet and straight go in the kitchen or just straight go outside. No. What you will do is you will first get up, wash your face with water. You'll brush your teeth. You'll use the washroom. Then you will come out, okay, and then probably you'll go to the kitchen, or probably you'll go out and see what is happening, or then you take a newspaper and read. So it depends, but every person has a sequence that they follow in the morning, or for that matter when you are getting ready for school. So what you can do, first you will wear your school uniform, okay. After that you will wear your school socks, you will wear your shoes, you will comb your hair. Okay. So there will be a sequence that you follow. So supposing aap pehle uniform pehnte ho, then you comb your hair. So there will be some sequence that you need to follow before doing everything. Okay. So similarly, here in the picture, you can see, observe the picture and write proper order of activities. Now, what is there out here? She's first washing the vegetables. Here she's eating the vegetables and here she's cutting the vegetable. Now, can you wash and eat immediately? We need to first cut it. So what will come as one? So this is 1, 2, and 3. Okay. Now, for this one, we need to see what has to be done first. Now, first here it is shown the child is in uniform with the school bag. Here the child is sleeping and here the child is playing football. Okay, so what according to you can come first? According to me, the first thing is first we sleep. Morning we get up and get ready and go to school. Okay, and then once we go to school, we play with the football. Okay, so this is the order. Similarly, you need to write the order for this. You will write the numbers out here. Okay. And you can talk about any one thing. Any one thing of which you can do the ordering of. Okay. For example, when you are starting with the homework, what do you do? First, you take out your pencil, your eraser. Then you open your book. Then you write your name, your date. And then you start your work. Okay. So that is one order that you follow. One sequence you follow. So what is next after taking out pencil, you will take out eraser. So that is a sequence. What is next? That is the thing you do next. So you will tell what you do in one particular, for example, while doing your homework or while reading a book. What do you do? First, you will go to your bag. You'll take out the note textbook from your bag. Then you'll open the textbook to the page number and then you will start reading. Correct? So any one example like this you will talk about, okay? And you will also take a picture of this page, write your name and send it to me, okay? That's all what you need to do for maths. Now for EVS, we come to this page number 77. The chapter's name is Sounds, okay? Introduction to different sounds. There are different sounds which we hear in our daily lives, okay? So some sounds we hear every day, some sounds we hear sometimes, and some sounds we hear rarely, okay? Now these are the birds. What are they doing? They are chirping. So I have some sound out here on my laptop where the birds are chirping. Okay, so that was the sound of birds chirping. Then here there is shown a glass. Now a glass, when we put on the table, can you hear the sound? And now when we put it on the floor, the sound changes. It also depends on the surface. Okay, on the surface where we make the sound of the glass. Then we have the sound of the sticks. So there can be different kind of sticks that you can use. Okay, so this, can you hear this? But now this, if I bang on my table, the sound changes. And now if this I bang on the, can you hear? So these are all the different kinds of sounds that you can hear. Then when we clap, when we tap on the table, okay, so these sounds are all different. Then this is the sound of the bell. Correct? Now I have two different balls out here. Okay, one big and one small. When I will bounce it on the floor, okay, it will make different sounds. Can you hear that? And when I bounce this small ball, it's a different sound. Correct? So each thing has a different sound. Now what is the sound of a cat? Yes, so that is the sound of a cat. Now we have a pencil box out here, but I'll show you with the crayon box. So can you see? So this is again a different sound. Okay? So all the items do have a different sound. Similarly, there are lots of musical instruments which have different sounds. Now what is written out here is, it is not necessary to have a musical instrument to play music. Now if we need to play music, we don't need to necessarily have a musical instrument with ourselves. Okay, hamare paas musical instrument nahi hai, tabhi bhi hum sound kar sakte hain. It is not necessary to have knowledge about classical music to play these musical instruments. Different kinds of sounds can be created by beating any two simple available objects. Okay, for example, even if I am taking this, I can create a sound. Okay, so different kinds of sounds can be created. These sounds can accompany the singer while singing. Children can be made to listen to such music, and they can also be made to imitate different sound of animals and birds. We have already done lot of sounds of animals. Okay, so there are different sounds which each have, and it's unique. Wo alag hi hota hai, wo kisi ke saath mix nahi ho sakta hai. So each and every object will make a different sound. Now what you all have to do is, you all, whatever objects you all have at home, you all will make sound of that, take a video and send it to me, okay? So whatever objects you have at home, from here or from anywhere else, which you can think about, you will take a video of that and send it to me, okay? That's all for the day. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.